Today, I wish to consider here before you short questions from chapter number 1, Partnership Accounts, and these questions are given in section B. Just observe. Answer in one sentence only. Chapter is Partnership Accounts. First question. What is the maximum limit of partners in a partnership firm? So what should be the maximum numbers of partners that there could be in a partnership firm? Now, for a partnership firm, there should be minimum 2. Maximum 10 in case of banking business. Otherwise, maximum number is 20. Observe. There should be minimum 2 persons to form a partnership. Minimum 2 persons are required to form a partnership. The maximum number of partners in a firm carrying on banking business should not exceed 10 and in any other business 20. So for a banking business, maximum number of partners should be 10 and for any other business it should be maximum 20. Now this limit is prescribed not in Partnership Act. This limit has been prescribed under the Companies Act. And remember one thing, if the number of members are more than 10 in case of banking business, it is identified as an illegal association. Similarly, if the number of members exceeds 20 for any other business, it is identified as illegal association. Next. Why partnership deed is desirable in a written form? To avoid possible disputes, it is desirable to have a partnership deed in writing. By this, issues amongst partners are solved in accordance with the provisions of partnership agreement. So to avoid disputes, in future, a written partnership agreement is necessary. Next. In the absence of partnership deed, in which ratio partners would share profits and losses? Here in should not be there. Now you know that in the absence of clarification in a partnership deed or partnership agreement, profits or loss is divided equally amongst partners. Next. Write a journal entry to close partners' joint account at the end of the year. Now, drawings are made by the partner during the year at any time, or frequent drawings are there during the year. All such drawings are debited to drawings account during the year. Then, total drawings at the end of the year are transferred to the capital account of the partner in case of fluctuating capital method. Or it is transferred to current capital account of a partner when there is a fixed capital accounting method. Observe it. The drawings account is to be closed at the end of the year. And under fluctuating capital accounting method, it is transferred to the capital accounts. While under fixed capital accounting method, it is transferred to current account. For this purpose, journal entry past is as under. So, partners, capital account / current account debit to partners joint account credit, being balance of partners joint account transfer to capital or current account as the case may be. This is how the journal entry for transfer gets recorded. Next. In the absence of partnership deed, at what rate interest will be calculated on a loan given by a partner to a partnership firm? Now also, in the absence of any agreement or clarification in the partnership agreement or deed, interest at the rate of 6% per annum is allowed on the balance of loan advanced by a partner to the firm. Now 6% interest is allowed. Under what circumstances? When there is a no agreement between partner giving loan and the partnership firm, one. Or when is there is no stipulation in the partnership deed about the interest on, at what rate interest on loan given by a partner should be paid. In those two situations, the interest on partner's loan to a firm is to be calculated at the rate of 6% per annum. Next. What do you mean by debit balance of profit and loss appropriation account? Debit balance of profit and loss appropriation account means divisible loss. This loss is transferred to the debit side of partner's capital account or current account. Now, divisible loss is a loss that occurs after distribution of profit as agreed. And the distribution of profit as per agreement is disclosed and reported in profit and loss appropriation account. Next. When fluctuating capital accounts are maintained, to which account will you credit interest on capital? Observe the answer. After recording the opening balance of capital on the credit side of capital account, additional capital brought during the year, interest on capital, salary, bonus, commission, remuneration, interest on loan, his share in divisible profit are credited to the capital account. Here the question is about only interest on capital. So in an examination, students should write only interest on capital is credited to the capital account. But for your academic interest, I have mentioned all the various other items that gets credited to the capital account that has been here demonstrated with an academic interest. But in examination, students should write basically interest on capital. Next. Where would you show credit balance of partner's capital account in the annual accounts of the firm? The closing credit balance of a partnership capital account is shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. On the liability side of the balance sheet, it is reported. Remember, where would you show the credit balance of partner's capital? Here I have added the word closing credit balance. That's an important understanding. Next. What is the need of or what is the need to open partner's current account? If the capital accounts are prepared under fixed capital method, a current account for each partner is also prepared for additional entries related to a partner, such as interest on capital, salary, bonus, commission, remuneration, interest on loan, drawings, interest on drawings, share in divisible profit or loss, etc. The balance of current account may be credit or debit. Now here I have demonstrated what is recorded under current in a current capital account and what is need to open. So first answer, when you want to maintain a capital under the fixed capital accounting system, you should maintain a current capital account. But the real purpose behind maintaining a current capital account is that a fixed capital amount is permanently kept in the firm, and every year partner should withdraw only in proportion or only within the restriction of profit distributed to the partners. If during the year profit distributed is 1 lakh, by any mode, bonus, commission, etc., 1 lakh is the amount credited to the partner's capital account, and his withdrawals are 80,000, that means partner has withdrawn less than what is credited to his share of what is credited to his current account by way of share in profit. The moment the current account shows a negative debit balance, it shows that partners has withdrawn or used the funds of the firm more than what he is expected to do. This is the real purpose. Next. The interest on drawing account will be shown to which side of profit and loss appropriation account. Now, interest on drawing is a gain or an income to a partnership firm, and it gets credited to the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account. Observe the answer. Interest on drawing by a partner from the firm and interest on the debit balance of a partner's current account are credited to the profit and loss appropriation account. So interest on drawings and interest on debit balance of current account is to be credited to profit and loss appropriation account. Next. In which account of partners divisible profit will be credited when fluctuating capital accounts of the partners are maintained? Now here, look at the answer. Divisible profit will be credited to the capital account when fluctuating capital accounts of partners are maintained. This is a very simple question. Next. Where would you credit permanent additional capital brought in by a partner when fixed capital account method is adopted? So additional capital brought is to be credited to the fixed capital account. That's the answer. Observe the answer on the screen. Permanent additional capital brought in by a partner under fixed capital account method is credited to the capital account, that is fixed capital account, and not to a current capital account. Next. Under which capital account method both capital accounts and current capital accounts are maintained? Observe the answer. Under fixed capital account method, both capital accounts and current capital accounts are maintained. Very simple question. Next. What is partnership deed for a partnership firm? Just read the answer. A written agreement between partners containing all the rules and regulations, means terms and conditions of a partnership firm, is known as partnership deed. It must be signed by all partners and be stamped properly. So it is a constitution of a partnership firm. The terms and conditions with which the partnership relationship came into existence, and all those terms and conditions, which is the basic fundamental for the maintenance of partnership relationship, and all those terms and conditions are recorded, which are agreed between the partners, and that is known as partnership deed or partnership agreement. Next. What is fluctuating capital account method? Observe the answer. A fluctuating capital accounts of the partners are called fluctuating when the balance of capital accounts keeps on changing every year. All the entries related to partners, such as drawings, interest on capital, partner salary, commission, share in profit and loss, are recorded in such one capital account maintained for each partner. When in one capital account all these things are recorded, so capital balance fluctuate year after year. Every year it fluctuates. That's why it is known as fluctuating capital account method. In the absence of any instruction given in the partnership deed, the capital accounts are prepared by fluctuating capital method. So this method of capital accounting is followed by default. Next. What is fixed capital account method? Observe the answer. A fixed capital account, what is that method? A method of preparing capital accounts according to which the capital balance of the partner remain fixed during the lifetime of the firm or for a very long period until there is a change that occurs by agreement. It can change only when there is a change in the profit sharing ratio or additional capital introduced or withdrawn by the partners as agreed. Next. What is current account of a partner? Observe the answer. If capital accounts are prepared under fixed capital method, a current account of each partner also be prepared for every additional entries related to a partner, such as drawings, interest on drawings, interest on capital, partner salary, commission, and share of partner in additional profit or loss. To record all these things, one account is maintained, is known as current capital account of a partner. The balance of this current capital account may be a debit balance or credit balance. When the amount withdrawn or taken away by the partner is less than various ways the profit gets credited to this current account, in that situation there will be a credit balance. Otherwise, there will be a debit balance. Next. Write a formula to determine commission of a manager when he is paid certain commission from surplus of profit after charging such commission. You have to write a formula for that. Observe it. It's simple. If a commission of a manager is based on a net divisible profit after charging such commission, then the formula for commission, divisible profit before commission, into rate plus 100 plus rate, this is the formula. Suppose that 10% commission is to be given, then the 10% is the rate. So 10 divided by 110 is to be multiplied with the divisible profit before commission to get the commission as per this stipulation. Next. What other items are shown other than net profit on the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account? Now, profit and loss appropriation account is credited with the net profit, means balance of profit and loss account, and over and above that, interest on drawings and interest on debit balance of current capital account, if charged as per agreement, that is also credited to profit and loss appropriation account. Observe it. After writing net profit, which is transferred from profit and loss account to the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account, as per agreement, interest on drawings by a partner and the interest on debit balance of partner's current capital accounts are credited. This is what is credited to profit and loss appropriation account. Next. Can partner be given a salary in the absence of provision in partnership deed regarding salary? Observe the answer. Very simple question. In the absence of provision in the partnership agreement or deed, partner is not entitled to salary. So partner is given salary if it is agreed or it is as per the partnership deed. Otherwise, it is the duty of a partner to work for the firm, and when such duty is casted, remuneration need not be paid. This is how these small questions are being explained to you. I think you must have followed all these things. Thanks to all of you.